What's up? It's me, Bobby V. You remember me, right?
Live on the phone from the USA, Bobby, formerly known as Bobby Valentino. How you doing?
Good. What's going on?
What part of America are you calling from?
I'm in the A-Town right now, Atlanta.
Is that where you live?
Yes. That's where I'm from, the ATL.
Okay, for real, man. What's the full reason behind not using Bobby Valentino anymore?
Well, due to the success of my first album, you know, I was real big overseas, and so I was actually coming over there doing, you know, a little touring. And it was a dude over there that already had the name trademark. So, you know, he sued me. And, you know, hey, well, I had to change the name.
Oh, for real, man. Because, I mean, the name had a good ring.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I'm still Bobby Valentino in the States and stuff, but this is only in London.
Oh, okay. For real, man.
But other places I can use it, though.
Yeah. Your debut album was a monster. How do you rate your new album entitled Special Occasion with your first album?
I mean, it's self-explanatory. It's definitely going to be a special occasion, you know what I'm saying? If you got my first album, you already know how I do it. So it's going to be that plus 10, you know. It's going to be real hot. Something you can ride through from beginning to end. It's going to be crazy.
Yeah, man, I'm looking forward to hearing this album, man. The first song we heard from your new album over here in London was called Wreck. Was there a reason why you never used this as your first single?
Well, you know, see, I really took my time recording this album. I could have easily, you know, just put an album out, you know, right behind my first album because I had the hype and everything, but I didn't want to do that for my fans. Like, I wanted to take my time and make sure this album was a quality R&B album. So, in the meantime, in between time, what I did, I kind of leaked a lot of songs that I was recording that I knew wasn't going on my album. You know what I'm saying? I kind of leaked them out there, you know, just to, you know, give my fans something to ride to, you know, and just to, you know, to keep, you know, help build the buzz and keep myself out there.
Okay, so your first single in the US is going to be the same one as London, yeah?
Yeah. It's called Anonymous.
Yeah, man, I recently heard this song, man. Who produced this track?
Timbaland. He's actually featuring on the song.
I played it on my show last week, and the phone lines went crazy. they really like it already, man. Yeah, Anonymous, they're loving it.
That record is crazy, man. Anonymous, you know, it's going to be a big record.
Yeah, tell us about the song, please, Anonymous.
It's kind of a spin-off, Slow Down, you know, Slow Down. I was looking for, you know, I saw a girl and I was telling her to slow down because I really wanted to know her, you know. Anonymous is kind of the same thing, you know, a twist off that because I've traveled the world, but I'm still looking for this special young lady, you know, that's going to be Miss Valentino. So, you know, I've met a lot of girls, but I think that one that I'm looking for is a little, she's Anonymous.
All right, man, introduce it to my listeners. Let's get it on for you.
Yo, what up? This your boy Bobby V, kicking it with the homie DJ Carlos, and you hearing it first right here, my brand new single, Anonymous, on Touch FM. Holla at your boy. DJ, don't drop that thing, man.
Fuck. For a minute it was looking like I didn't love one of those guys. Looking for a special lady to save me. Maybe I'll never be satisfied. Had a couple bad looks and a couple dimes. Looking for you, why it's so hard to find.
I thought I took one step, I took two back. I'm not even close this time, and that's a fact.
There you have it, London Man. What a single, man, produced by the one Timbaland. It's killing it right now. It's going to blow big time, and especially I feel it's going to be as big a slowdown, if not bigger, man. Definitely a nice song. Tim and Bob and you work great together. Are they your favorite producers?
Man, definitely, man. Tim and Bob are my favorite producers because we have, like, our chemistry and vibe is like none other. You know, I work with a lot of producers, but I don't vibe as well as I do with Tim and Bob. It's kind of like a marriage, you know what I'm saying? So I work with a lot of great producers on this album, like Rodney Jerkins, Timbaland, Duran Vidal, Brian Cox, and I got hot records from all of them. But, you know, it's just the whole vibe when I'm with Tim and Bob that's a little different, you know?
Yeah, I can feel that in the songs that you do with them, man, because I can definitely feel that kind of feeling. I mean, you did a track with them on this album called Tired of Being Alone for the female fans. Has this changed now, or are you still single?
Definitely, man. I'm still single, man. I love to mingle, you know what I'm saying? Unfortunately, that song not going on the album. A lot of the songs that leaked out on the internet are not going on my album. Like I said, I knew it was going to be a long time before my next album came out, so I just wanted to, you know, to keep myself out there. I wanted to get my fans something to ride to. So, you know, don't get it twisted. You know, if you hear songs like on the internet or think that it's a leaked album, because it's not, you know, I got whole brand new tracks, you know, for my album. It's going to be crazy. It's all new tracks.
Oh, man, can we get this one on for the female fans? Tired of being alone? Introduce that one for me, please.
Yo, 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 what up? This your boy Bobby Valentino, man. It's Tired of Being Alone, an exclusive. It's not going on the album, but it's an exclusive. I repeat, an exclusive. I'll let your boy DJ Carlos drop that thing.
Yeah, man, that's for the female friends, man. Tired of being alone. Produced by Tim and Bob. They are hot as hell, man, for real, man. So when are you coming over to London?
I'm trying to get out there this summer. That's my goal, and I don't want to just come. I had opportunities to come, but I'm real busy, so I didn't just want to come for 2 or 3 days. I want to come and spend some time over there.
When you came over and you done that concert back in 2005, New Year's Eve with Pretty Ricky, how did you feel the fans took you?
It was real hot. Pretty Ricky, good friends of mine, you know what I'm saying? So I love doing shows with them and like just vibing with them is crazy too, because I think we got a good chemistry together.
Yeah, man, definitely. I mean, the crowd went crazy when you came on,
and
man.
They got a big song out right now over in the States. I don't know how it's doing over there, but it's doing
really good over here, man, for real, man.
Yeah, yeah. So
on this album, A Special Occasion, what story do you feel this album is telling the world about Bobby?
Well, you know, this album right here,
yeah,
it's really a step up. Like, I really challenged myself, you know. My first album was very successful, so, you know, I really wanted to take my time with it, and I really wanted to step my game up. So I challenged myself locally. I challenged myself, you know, when I perform, you know, all the way across the board, you know. So it was like a personal challenge to myself to make sure this album was hotter and even more successful than the first one.
Yeah, man, for real, man. In your opinion, Bobby, do you feel R&B is getting better and better?
Yeah, R&B is on the rise, you know. Hip-hop is real big right now, but R&B is coming back, you know, and that's one of my goals, is to be a part of the movement of bringing R&B back, you know, how it was back in the day, you know, when I was coming up, you know, Jodeci, Boyz II Men, groups like that, they used to be, you know, real huge. They were actually bigger than the rappers, but now it's like the rappers are bigger than the singers, so just trying to bring R&B back to where it used to be.
No, definitely, man. You and Neo holding it down big time right now.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, man. How's Ludacris? And has he featured on any tracks on this album?
He's not on the album, but he's good. You know, I mean, I talk to him all the time. You know, I didn't want to put a lot of features on this album because I think that sometimes I'm still establishing myself as a new artist, and sometimes features, you know, overshadow the artist. You know, like if they see Ludacris on the song on my album, and let's say it's number 8 on my album, they'll go straight to number 8 because Ludacris on that song, and they'll miss out on 1-7.
All right, for real. Well, Bobby, man, thank you for taking that time and calling us in London. Is there anything else you'd like to say to your UK fans?
Man, all my fans over in the UK, man, I love y'all. Make sure y'all go get this new album, Special Occasion. It'll be in store in April, man. April, Special Occasion, your boy Bobby V. This album is hot. It's going to be real hot. If you got my first album, you already know how I do it. I can't wait to come over there. Man, make sure you go get this album. Holla at your boy.
Man, definitely. Before we go, introduce one of your favorite slow jams on the album, and we'll get it on right now.
Hey, man, my album is filled with heaters from beginning to the end, you know, so I can't even say my favorite, but right now, I want you to play Anonymous one more time, because that record right there is, I'm really feeling that record right now. I hope y'all feeling it too.
No, I'm definitely feeling it, man.
Featuring Timbaland, produced by Timbaland. Holla at your boy.
All right, man. Take care. See you over in London soon, man. And good luck with your album out in April and your first single, Anonymous, man. Thanks for calling, man. Take care, yeah?
Yes, sir.
All right, man. Bye. Bye.
For a minute, it was looking like I didn't know one of those guys. Looking for a special lady to save me. Maybe I'll never be satisfied. Had a couple of bad looks and a couple dimes. Looking for you. Why it's so hard to find? I thought I took one step. I took two back. I'm not even close this time. And that's a fact. All I know is that we be the perfect match. So where you at, love? I just gotta find. Baby, I won't.
Kathy Lee.
Oh, Kathy Lee.
Wanna hold my hand?
Wanna hold my hand?
Come get with me.
Come get with me.
Which dime wanna ride?
Which dime wanna ride?
Everything on me.
Everything on me.
Girl, you ain't gotta lie.
Girl, you ain't gotta lie.
Tell me what's it gon' be.
Tell me what's it gon' be.
I gotta know.
I gotta know.
I gotta know.
Another one.